Hello, my lovely, lovely people. You're welcome again to my YouTube channel. If today is your first time of stopping by, you're highly, highly welcome. My name is Ijeoma Gloria, a YouTuber based in Italy. Please head over to the subscribe button, hit that subscribe button, and of course the notification bell that says all. It will notify you each time a new video pops up from this channel. To my old and returning subscribers, you all are amazing. I love you so much and I really appreciate your support, and I promise not to disappoint you. I'll keep bringing lit content, okay? So in today's video, we are going to be looking at the term complain. Those of you that are on this table, get ready, because today we are shaking the table. Those of you that are working in the Public Complaint Commission, those of you that are directors in the complaining business, please get ready, because today we are shaking you off. So if you're ready, let's get into the video. At the term complain. Complain is expressing dissatisfaction or unhappiness over a situation or thing. We are not looking at complain in the medical area. We are not looking at complain in the law court. That's not what we're talking about today. We are talking about complain as when you're always expressing yourself, you're always angry about a situation, you can't keep it to yourself, you're so angry. We are all guilty in one way or the other. As human beings, we are bound to complain when things are not going the way we planned or the way we expect. But what we are saying is it shouldn't be a habit. Let people not know you for complaining. When you're going to your child's school, people see you and they say, oh, this man, he's going to complain again. Oh, this lady, she has come with her trouble. No, that's not right. Let people not see you that way. In the church, you complain. When you go to the gym, you're complaining. You go to shops to buy something, you're complaining. You are always complaining. You're known for being someone that complains a lot. That is what we're talking about today. Someone may ask, can't I speak out again? No, my dear, calm down. That's not what we're talking about. What we're trying to say is that it shouldn't be part of you. It shouldn't be a habit. Now, let's look at this factor together. Whatever you're complaining about today is someone's prayer point, is someone's wish. Someone is even ready to accept less of what you're complaining about. Where you are today is someone's prayer point. Someone is praying, oh, can I be this lady that has gotten married? Can I be this lady that has even one child? Can I be this lady that is fair? Can I be this lady that is dark? Oh, I want to be fat. Oh, I want to be slim. Oh, I want to have this money. Oh, I want to do this. I want to do that. What you're complaining about is someone's prayer point. So each time you want to complain, remember that what you want to complain is what someone is even asking God. God, please, can you just give me this thing? I will be so grateful. So when next you want to complain, let this be a guiding factor. Another thing we are going to look at is happiness, joy. Happiness and joy comes easier when you stop complaining about your problems and start being grateful for what you have and who you are. If you have a grateful heart, you will stop complaining. You will be appreciative of what you have. You wake up in the morning to say, God, I thank you. I appreciate you. Some people are in the prison. Some are in the mortuary. Some are in the hospital. But you are alive, healed, and hearty. So whatever it is, as long as there is life, there is hope. Most of us, our life is like this blank paper. Let's look at this blank paper. If I tell a lot of us to talk about this blank paper, everybody will keep telling me they are seeing a dot on it. But I tell you, if you can see that this paper is white, it will help you to stop complaining. Why are you complaining about the black dot in this paper when this paper is filled with a lot of white spaces and just that black dot you're complaining? No, my sister, my brother, my friend, let's stop it. I am guilty. We are all guilty, and we can encourage ourselves. When you look at this paper, say to yourself, oh, I can see it's all white, but there is a little dot which I can fix. Don't look at it that, oh, this paper has a black dot. When you focus on the black dot, that is when you have that mindset to complain. Okay? Complaining will convince people that you can't even take control of your life. You can't control certain things that happen in your life. Rather than spend time to complain, channel that time to finding solutions. Rather than murmur, get angry, channel that time to see how you can make things better. At this point, please, have you subscribed to my channel? If you have not subscribed, please go over to the subscribe button. Hit that subscribe button. It is red. I don't want to see the red anymore. And the notification option that says all, it will notify you each time a new video like this pops up in this channel. Please, I don't want to complain about this. Okay? Help me do that. Also, leave me a beautiful comment. The comment helps me to interact with you, to appreciate you more, and then to also learn from you. Like this video and share to your family and friends. I will really, really be thankful. Okay? Finally, complaining is finding fault, and wisdom, on the other hand, is finding solution. Which party do you want to belong? The choice is yours today. Another thing about complaining is that it gives a kind of stigma. People would dislike you. When people say you come in, they begin to panic. They would dislike you for who you are. They begin to say, oh, she's coming again. She's going to complain. People will begin to bet on your behalf. Bet me this woman will complain this morning. Bet me this man is going to complain. Even on days when you choose to be happy and not complain, people will remind you, oh, sir, you're not complaining today. Oh, sir, did I get it right? Oh, madam, you're happy today. People will even remind you to complain. That's how bad it is when you begin to complain. Avoid complaining. Because even when you have people around you, they begin to panic. Maybe you have people working under you. You're always complaining. You're always harassing them. When they see you coming, they begin to panic. Even if they are doing the right thing, they are panicking. Because they know that whether they get it right or wrong, you will still complain. So I want to encourage us to avoid complaining because of the stigma it will give us. People will dislike us. People will live in fear. Now, another thing about complaining is that when you complain a lot, even the things you're believing God for, even the things you're hoping for, the things you're wishing for, when they come, you forget to appreciate. You will even complain. Maybe you're asking God for something. God, bless me with a child, bless me with this business success, bless me with this idea, bless me with this or that. When the blessing eventually comes, you forget to be thankful. You say, ah, God, I asked you for a child, but had it been it was a boy, I would have preferred it though. You gave me a girl. Well, let me take it. You're still complaining. Even in your prayer point that has been answered, you're still complaining. That's why complaining is bad. Don't let it be part and parcel of you. Another thing I don't like about complaining is that it's infectious. You notice that when you complain a lot, people around you will begin to complain unknowingly. Because when you come in the midst of people, you say, oh, this one happened, that one didn't happen, this one happened, that one is happening, this and that. People will learn from you. And when you sit to discuss with people, that is how you're going to discuss. You're going to be discussing negative things. You're going to be complaining. You're going to be talking about this or that in a negative way. So complaining is bad because it is so infectious. Stop complaining. Now, one last tip I want to give us that can help us to stop complaining is, if you find yourself where you can help a situation before it gets bad, please do it. For example, if you walk into a restaurant to eat, tell them what you like and what you don't like. Tell them, please, is your food spicy? Please, I don't like this. Or tell people what you want. If you need to register your child in a school, tell your the school authority, please, my child is allergic to cold. I wouldn't like this to happen. Not when it happens, you begin to complain. You didn't tell anybody. So why are you complaining? It's good if you can tell people what you want politely. But rather than wait and things go bad and you begin to shout, fine, once you can say it, but when you make it a habit, that is what I'm trying to drive at in this video. Don't make complaining a habit. Now, the last one I want to encourage us, be thankful. Always be thankful. Be grateful. Stop worrying too much, especially with the things you cannot change. Smile and let go. All right, lovely people, it's time to draw the curtain at this juncture. I hope today's video has inspired you to stop complaining. If it has, it will also inspire someone. So why not share this video to your friends and your family? Before we go, I want you to come closer. It's a secret. Yes, we are having a no complaint challenge. We're going to start with 24 hours. Tell yourself, I can do it. For 24 hours, that's one day there will be no complaint. From 24 hours to 72 hours, which is 3 days, from 3 days to 1 week and 1 month. Tell yourself, I will not complain. I will remain appreciative of where I am and who I am. Start with that, and I tell you, your life will never remain the same. I love, love, love you all. Stay blessed, stay safe. See you next time. Bye.